Welcome back to the lesson on solving nonlinear equations using open methods. In the previous video, we introduced the Newton-Raphson method in multiple dimensions. If we want to solve simultaneously for several functions that are functions of more than one variable, in this video we will use the method in an example. Now, if we have two functions presented like that. Actually, I can give you a hint. These two functions present the slopes of the surface of a hemisphere. Actually, if we have a hemisphere, the upper part of the hemisphere, the part that's above the zero, this sphere has a center at 1 and 1. If you try to differentiate the function for that hemisphere with respect to x and with respect to y, you will get f1 and f2 simultaneously. However, even if we don't know that and we want to find a solution, a simultaneous solution for the roots of f1 and f2, given both of them in this form, and we have a starting guess of 0.5 and 0.5. The first thing we do is differentiate each of the functions with respect to each of the variables. So what we will need to do is differentiate f1 with respect to x and then with respect to y, then go to f2 and differentiate it with respect to x and then with respect to y. We can do this right away using basic calculus, basic differentiation, or maybe you can use a symbolic manipulator like maxima. As a matter of fact, I used maxima to make sure that my differentiation doesn't have any mistake in it, in order not to present a wrong example. However, it's a nice exercise to differentiate these two functions, each with respect to the variables x and y. The derivatives will look like this. Here is partial f1 by partial x. Don't worry if they are too weird, but they are exact. I don't really care much about how they look, because at the end of the day, the computer is going to substitute the values in it. I'm not going to do this by hand. Also, you will find that the square root of x1 minus x minus 1 all squared minus y minus 1 all squared is there in all the denominators. So if you just evaluate this once, you can use it in each of the derivatives we have here. We can now use this right away into the program by differentiating, by inverting the matrix and multiplying it by f1, f2 to get the change. Use the change to find the new guess and repeat a few more times. Of course, as I said, this will not be an easy task to perform by hand. So let's go to Octave and see how we can create a program using Newton-Raphson method to find the solution of multiple variables, multiple functions, with multiple variables. Here we start the program by clearing everything. Then here you have the initial guesses and the tolerance and the maximum number of iterations, initiating the counter and the error. Okay, so here you go to the heart of the program or the main loop. First step, we evaluate the square root. As I said a few seconds earlier, you need to evaluate this square root because you're going to use it a lot. Then actually f1 is 1 minus x over that square root, and f2 is 1 minus y over the same square root. The derivatives also, you can use them here directly from the relations we obtained in the presentation. X minus 1 all squared over the square root cubed minus 1 over the square root. Here, of course, don't forget the negative signs. f1y, which is the derivative of f1 with respect to y, is exactly equal to f2x, simply because this came from the derivative of the equation of a sphere. I'm not going to get into the details of that, but as you can see, they came out the same. F2y is just like f1x, but instead of having x minus 1 all squared, you're having here y minus 1 all squared. Now you have all the elements that are needed in the Jacobian matrix. Create the Jacobian matrix. Here the first row is the derivative of the derivatives of f1 with respect to the variables, and the second row is the derivatives of the second function with all the variables. Then we invert the Jacobian, multiply the inverted Jacobian by a vector of f1 and f2 to get how much change do we need in x. Then we use that to find the new values of x by adding the first element of the deltas to x and the second element to y. Of course, if you have more than two variables, it's preferred to create a loop to do that, but I preferred here to introduce a simpler version of the program so that you will see clearly how it works. But if you have n variables, then now you really need to create a set to create a loop that works on each variable separately. Finally, we evaluate the error. The error here, as you can see, is the dot product of the changes we had. If the changes are quite small, then the error will be small enough for us to stop. We check if we are extremely lucky squared, if the functions are zero or not. Then we see if the error is less than the tolerance, or if the counter or the number of iterations we made is more than the allowed number of iterations. If any of these conditions is true, then we break the loop. Otherwise, we go back and re-evaluate the function and its derivative and so on until delta x becomes small enough. Here you see, if we run the program, in only four iterations, you get an error of 10 to the minus 9. Okay, which is, remember, this is the dot product of the changes in x. This is quite nice. We get the exact values of the solution, 1 and 1, with the functions equal to 6.1 and 6.1 times 10 to the minus 5. This was, as you can see, the solution is quite symmetric, simply because we have a symmetric function and we started with a symmetric solution. A symmetric guess. If we change this guess to any other value, but this value has to be inside the circle, which cuts the hemisphere or cuts the sphere into two halves. Otherwise, you will get an error. Then you will find, again, you will get to almost the same solution in quite a small number of iterations. So that's how we used the Newton-Raphson method to solve the problem. What if we wanted to use the modified Newton-Raphson method instead of the Newton-Raphson method? Here, again, these two programs are already uploaded on GitHub. The same program is there. Now, for the sake of using the function several times, I created a functions and called it getFunks. GetFunks, here you are, here it is, it takes x and y and evaluates f1 and f2, that's all. So it just evaluates f1 and f2. If we get back here, we go to creating a small change in x, dx and dy. Here you can notice that I didn't create the check for whether x or y is equal to 0. Just to simplify the program, but I guess you need to use that in case you don't know the shape of the function you are looking for. Then what did we do? We sent the new variables x plus dx to get funks. So what I get is the function f1 of x plus delta x and y, here f2 of x plus delta x and y. Similarly, I send that to get the functions with the y plus delta y. I'm using the function here, the same function getFunks. I'm using it or calling it three times. Then use these f1x, f2x, f1y, and f2y to get the slopes. Maybe I should have changed the variable names here. Let me f1dx, f2dx, f1dy, f2dy. Now, d. So that's just to remove any confusion. These are the values of the functions at x plus delta x here and here. Sorry, here and here. These are the values of the functions at y plus delta y for f1 and f2. And I use them to get the slopes of the functions. Then proceed just like the modified, just like the Newton-Raphson method to find everything else. If you run this, you will find that for the same number of iterations, we got almost the same solution, which means that the modified Newton-Raphson, at least in this problem, is working fine and getting us to the solution with almost the same number of iterations. Modified Newton-Raphson is extremely powerful, as we always say about Newton-Raphson methods. I almost use Newton-Raphson in every nonlinear problem I try to solve, and it always works. That doesn't mean that it will work in every single problem you will face, but for me, I'm lucky enough that Newton-Raphson is good enough for all my problems, so I use it all the time, and I had no problems with it. I hope this made the Newton-Raphson method for multiple variables and multiple functions clear. And I hope this will make you satisfied with using open methods to find the solution or the roots of functions, whether in a single variable or in a multiple variable. This actually concludes our lesson about open methods. So now we know how to solve nonlinear equations using bracketing methods and open methods. And in open methods, we extended our usage of the algorithms to multiple dimensional methods. This is this will give you enough tools to solve most of the problems that you will be facing in practical life. However, there is always something special that will need further studying. We will not cover this in our course here. The next lesson will be about interpolation. Following that, we will go to regression. Both actually lie under the title of fitting, curve fitting of data. So I hope you join us next lesson. And thank you very much for your patience. Thank you. See you later.